My dear students, now we have to see about the structure of the tobacco mosaic virus and bacteriophage. Tobacco mosaic virus was first discovered by Dmitry Ivanovsky in the year 1892 and from the tobacco mosaic plant. He only first identified the tobacco mosaic virus from the infected tobacco mosaic plant. The disease will be, tobacco mosaic disease will be spreading through vectors like aphids, locust means vertically, the tropical grasshopper with strong powers of flight will attack the tobacco mosaic plant and automatically transmit the tobacco mosaic virus and spread the tobacco mosaic disease. What are the symptoms of tobacco mosaic disease? First one, decoloration of the leaf color along the veins. If you see the veins, if you analyze the leaves, you can see the veins. Veins are the vascular tissue, part of the vascular tissues which supply water to the leaf and will take away the food materials from the leaf, away from the leaf. And that is, along the vein, you can see decoloration of the leaf color along the veins and show yellowing. Usually, the leaves are green in color. When the tobacco mosaic virus infecting the tobacco mosaic plant, decoloration of the green color takes place along the veins. So, all along the vein, the green color changes into yellow color. That is the first symptom. Second, green mottling, which is the mosaic symptom. You can see patches of green color patches, yellow color patches can be seen like mosaic. So that mosaic pattern of symptom is called green mottling. Then downward curling of the leaves. Leaves will bend downward. That is downward curling of the leaves and distortion of the young apical leaves occur. Then finally the plant becomes shortened and greatly the yield will be reduced greatly. So these are all the symptoms of the tobacco mosaic disease. Tobacco mosaic disease is caused by tobacco mosaic virus. The structure of the tobacco mosaic virus you have to see. Tobacco mosaic virus is a rod-shaped helical virus. Rod-shaped helical virus. It measures about 280 into 150 micrometer with a molecular weight of 39 into 10 to the power 6 Daltons. Each tobacco mosaic virus consists of outer protein coat that technically called capsid and a central core of single standard RNA as a nucleic acid. The protein coat is made up of 2130 identical protein subunits. Each subunit is called capsomer. The RNA consists of 6500 nucleotides. So these are all the information given for tobacco mosaic virus, structure of the tobacco mosaic virus. The diagram of the tobacco mosaic virus is given in the page number 5, figure 1.4. It is a helical virus, rod-shaped virus, consists of only two part, outer protein coat called capsid. Capsid consists of a number of subunits, that is called capsomer. At the center, there is a central core of nucleic acid. The nucleic acid is single stranded RNA that is packed at the center, which is surrounded by capsid, protein coat. That's a very simple structure. Right, come to the bacteriophage. Bacteriophages are viruses which infect bacteria. The virus which cause disease to bacteria. The virus which kill bacteria. The virus which eats bacteria. Literally, the bacteriophage means eaters of bacteria. In Greek word, phagin means to eat. So that is the meaning for that. The bacteriophage will take T4 bacteriophage. We'll see the structure of T4 bacteriophage. This is the T4 bacteriophage. It is tadpole-shaped structure. Consisting of a head, collar, and a long tail with base plate. These are all the structure you can see. The base plate, the head is hexagonal and consisting of 2000 identical protein subunits that is seen in the head of the T4 bacteriophage. Inside the hexagonal head, double-stranded DNA molecule is tightly packed. The tail is a long helical structure which includes a tubular core inside and connected to the head of the bacteriophage. This is the tail. Tail consists of two structures, outer tail sheath, and inner, there is a central core. The central core alone is connected with the head by means of collar. The collar can be seen at the junction between the head and the tail. At the end of the tail, there is a base plate. The base plate has six spikes or six tail pins. Six tail spikes or six tail pins, and also with the basal plate, six long tail fibers are connected. These tail fibers are used to attach the phage on the cell wall of the bacterial cell during replication. A long double-stranded DNA molecule is of about 50 micrometer is tightly packed inside the head. The DNA is about 10,000 times longer than the bacteriophage. So these are all the information given as far as the structure of the bacteriophage is concerned. So now we have seen about the structure of the tobacco mosaic virus and also the structure of the bacteriophage. That's all.